Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering and Aspen channel. As you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 17 for our valuable viewers. So this is our last lecture on building block number 3, which is stoichiometry. We have already covered building block number 1, which is mole balanced, related to chapter number 1 and chapter number 2 of the book Elements of Chemical Reaction Engineering by H. Scott Fogler. For the building block number 2, which is rate law, we have covered chapter number 3, and for building block number 3, we have covered chapter number 4, stoichiometry. So we will be solving the last example related to this chapter. Moving on to the example states that the reversible gas phase decomposition of nitrogen tetroxide N2O4 to nitrogen dioxide NO2, the reaction is N2O4 converts to 2 moles of NO2, however, it is a reversible reaction. The previous example was related to the irreversible reaction, but this example is related to the reversible reaction. The reaction is to be carried out at constant temperature. The feed consists of pure N2O4 at 340 Kelvin and 202.6 kPa or 2 atm. So we are assuming that the reaction temperature and pressure are constant in the system. The concentration equilibrium constant K of C at 340 Kelvin is 0.1 mole per cubic decimeter. And the rate constant is 0.5 per minute. Obviously, we need these values for the solution of the system. Now we have to solve the four tasks. Number one is to set up a stoichiometric table, and then we have to calculate the equilibrium conversion of N2O4 in a constant volume batch reactor. After doing this, we have to calculate the same one for the flow reactor. Then we have to assume that the reaction is elementary. Elementary means the stoichiometric coefficient is equal to the exponent of the species in the rate equation. So assuming the reaction is elementary, express the rate of reaction solely as a function of conversion for the flow and batch system. And finally, we have to determine the CSTR volume, which is required to achieve 80% of equilibrium conversion. So we will go at all of these one by one. Before going to the step, we have to first develop the relation for K of C. And that is that N2O4 in a reversible manner goes to 2NO2. We can write it as A to 2 moles of B. Accordingly, we write K of C as concentration of B at equilibrium square, because it is a stoichiometric coefficient. So accordingly, it will be in exponent, and accordingly divided by C of A at equilibrium. So after doing that, we will go to our first part. That is, first we need to develop the stoichiometric table. So how it can be prepared? Species is N2O4 and NO2, represented as symbol A and B. The initial number of moles are NA0 for A species, while there is no B present, so it will be 0. And NT0 is equal to NA0. So accordingly, the species is the limiting reactant, and its stoichiometric coefficient is already 1, so it will be minus NA0x. While for here, it will be B over A, but now B is positive. So it will be plus B over A, because it is product now, not a reactant. So plus 2 NA0 into X, once we sum these two, this N of A is equal to NA0 into 1 minus X, while N of B is equal to 0 plus 2, so obviously it will be 2 NA0X, and once we sum these two, it will be NT0 plus NA0X. Now we know that C of A is equal to NA over V. We have derived that expression previously, and that number of moles of A at the outlet is equal to number of moles at the inlet, NA0 into 1 minus the conversion. And for constant volume system, V is equal to V0. That V is the final V, and that is the initial. Now that NA0 over V0 goes to CA0 into 1 minus X. For C of B, NB over V, NB is equal to 2 NA0X, and NA0 over V0, this will become as CA0. So CB is equal to 2 moles of CA0X. So C of B is equal to 2 into CA0 into X. For CA0, we know the relation that it is equal to Y0 into CT0, and CT0 is equal to P0 over RT0. Now Y0 is obviously 1 in the system, because only A is present. P0 is 2 atm. The value of R is 0.082, and T0 is 340 Kelvin. So the answer will be 0.07174 mole per cubic decimeter. For K of C, if we substitute the value CB at equilibrium, it is equal to 2 moles of CA0X, but now this X will be X of E, because we are talking about the equilibrium. And accordingly, C of A, E is equal to 1 minus X of E. And finally, once we rearrange it to get expression in terms of equilibrium conversion, x of E is equal to square root k of C into 1 minus x of E over 4 CA naught. So this is our first part of the system. Moving to the second part for the flow system, we know that CA is equal to FA over small v. This F means the flow rate, that small v is also flow rate. F is smaller flow rate, while v is the volumetric flow rate. Now, if you remember that v is equal to v naught 1 plus epsilon x, p naught over p, t over t naught. But since we are assuming that p and t are constant in the system, so these two terms will be excluded from the system, which are already done. Now, f a naught over v naught will become c a naught. So, c a naught 1 minus x and 1 plus epsilon x. For c of b, fb over v, fb is equal to 2 times f a naught x, in the same way as we have developed for the batch system. The same table will be developed, only the n will be replaced by the f. So 2 times f a naught x over v naught 1 plus epsilon x, f a naught over v naught will goes to c a naught x over 1 plus epsilon x. Now representing k of c is equal to cbe square over cae. Now cbe at equilibrium, now this expression will come here. Since it's the square, so 2 converts to 4, c a naught into x e square. Now c a naught is here because this c a naught will be cancelled out with this c a naught in the denominator. If you see c of a e is in the denominator, so c a naught will come here. Here it will be square, so square will be cancelled out with this term. So accordingly, 4 c a naught x e square over 1 minus x e over 1 plus epsilon x of e. And once you rearrange it, x in terms of x of e, it is equal to square root of k of c 1 minus x of e 1 plus epsilon x of e over 4 times c a naught. Now if we solve these, we get the values of x of e for batch reactor as 0.44, while for flow reactor as 0.51. How we can get it? We can use polymath to solve it, or we can use Excel to solve it. So that is not included in this lecture series. So once we go to the polymath, we will solve, take this example and we will solve this. Now moving to the next part, which is reaction follows an elementary rate law. We can write it as minus Ra is equal to K of A, C of A minus Cb square over K of C. For batch system, C of A goes to Ca naught 1 minus X and C of B goes to Ca naught X into 2. And since it's a square, so it will be 4 Ca naught square into X square over K of C. For flow system, in the same way, the equation will be same. However, the denominator will be added because the difference between these two is 1 plus epsilon x, and obviously there is pressure and temperature difference, but since these are constant, so not included. So accordingly, Ca naught 1 minus x and minus 4 T naught square into x square over KFC, these two are the same. The only difference is 1 plus epsilon x here and 1 plus epsilon x whole square here. Now, if we substitute the values, the value of K is 0.5 per minute. C a naught is 0.07714, so we round it off and 0.072 into 1 minus x, and the value of epsilon is 1 in the system. So 1 minus x over 1 plus x minus 4 C a naught, so 0.072 raised to power 2, x square over 0.1, which is K of C, 1 plus x raised to power 2. And if we take 0.072 common from here, which will be multiplied by this 0.5, so it will be 0.036, 1 minus x over 1 plus x minus 2.88 x square over 1 plus x raised to power 2. So that's how we write the rate equation as a function of conversion for batch system. As we have seen here, we have not substituted values here because we are not given the task to design batch reactor. We are given the task to design the flow reactor. So we will use this rate expression in the design equation. Now moving to part number 4, let's calculate the CSTR volume which is required to achieve 80% of equilibrium conversion of 51%. What does that mean? That actually the equilibrium conversion is 51%. And if you remember our problem statement, it was said that 80% of the equilibrium conversion. So equilibrium conversion is 0.51. So 80% of that 0.51 is 0.4. So it means the value of x is 0.4. Molar feed rate as 3 mole per minute. So accordingly, we are given this expression. Now we have, what we have to do, we have to put the value of x, which is 0.4, and to see that minus r is equal to 0.036, 1 minus x, so x is 0.4 over 1 plus x 0.4 minus 2.88 0.4 raised to power 2 over 1 plus 0.4 raised to power 2. So accordingly, it is 0.0070 mole per cubic decimeter per minute. And volume of CSTR is FA naught x over minus RA. This is the fundamental equation. FA0 is 3 mole per minute as given over here. X is 0.4, minus RA is 0.0070 mole per cubic decimeter per minute. And accordingly, we get the volume of CSTR as 171 cubic decimeter or 0.171 cubic meter. So this concludes our last numerical for this chapter, that we have followed all the procedure from start, that we have prepared the stoichiometric table, we have calculated the equilibrium conversion, we have done it actually for the reversible system, and finally we came to a point that we calculated the rate of reaction, we were given the value of equilibrium conversion from which we got the value of actual conversion, and we were given the flow rate, so we calculated the volume of CSTR. This is one of the representation that we have to now do that in our upcoming chapters. But there, the method will be a bit different. We will be following an algorithm to solve our numericals. And finally, is your building block stable? If yes, you are going in the right direction. If no, then you have to correct it before moving to the next building block, which is isothermal design. So I hope you have enjoyed the video. If you have any query suggestion, you can provide it to me in the comment box. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.